Did your eyes smile that same invitation? Then you are gone. Where, oh, where have you gone? How long must I stay in a world of illusion? Beware.
Filling blitz of the year. Crews expected to fill about 4,000 potholes on Toronto roads tomorrow. Amber, how are those roads looking now?
Well, unfortunately, delays on the eastbound side of the 401 out of Milton towards Trafalgar. That's where we have a vehicle fire. It's causing more of a delay on the westbound side, though. Pretty solid from about the 410 through this stretch as well. Better news on the westbound 401 collector lanes approaching the 400. Problems there mostly off to the left shoulder now. It's a collision. OPP are there on the scene.
Thanks so much, Amber. It is 2 degrees out there. It's warming up as the day comes to an end. A low of -8 tonight. Tomorrow, the sun will be out with a high of 2, a low of 3, and periods of rain. I'm Rashmi Nayar in for Jill Deacon. World This Hour is next.
Hi, I'm Joe Z. I'm a celebrity stylist and producer, and I'm championing the book, The Woo Woo by Lindsay Wong and Canada Reads 2019. One book to move you. In Chinese culture, we don't feel, we just live. We would never raise our hand and say we need help with our mental state. And I think Lindsay's book moves you to take action.
Canada Reads 2019. The battle begins March 25th. For more, go to cbcbooks.ca. The CBC News is next. Coming up in 90 minutes, it's As It Happens.
I'm Angeline Tedawayo. Tonight, after years of suspicion, R. Kelly is facing 10 counts of criminal sexual abuse, including abuse against minors. Our guest was one of the first to speak up online against the R&B star.
From CBC News, the world this hour.
I'm Tom Hamilton.
It's a step. It's not a victory, but it is an important step.
Alberta Premier Rachel Notley says her government will hold Ottawa's feet to the fire to make sure the Trans Mountain Pipeline expansion gets approved. Notley spoke after the National Energy Board once again gave a green light to the controversial project. The regulator says expanding the line is in the public interest, despite environmental concerns. Allison Dempster has the details.
6 months ago, the Federal Court of Appeal told the National Energy Board to do more homework on the effects of the pipeline expansion, including the impact of increased tanker traffic on marine life off the BC coast. In its report today, the regulator concludes that it's likely to cause significant adverse effects on the southern resident killer whale. Robert Stedman is the chief environmental officer with the National Energy Board.
While these effects weighed heavily in the NEB's reconsideration, the NEB recommends that the Government of Canada find that they can be justified in the circumstances in light of the considerable benefits of the project and measures to mitigate the effects.
The regulator is recommending measures to deal with everything from increased underwater noise to marine spill response. Federal officials have said a final decision on Trans Mountain won't be made until consultations with First Nations are complete. Allison Dempster, CBC News, Calgary.
Indigenous leaders on the West Coast say they're disappointed with the NEB's decision. Chief Judy Wilson is with the Neskonlith First Nation.
Our orcas are in crisis. It's a complete disregard for our whale population.
Let me see those hands, let me see those hands, let me see them. Come on, let me see those hands, let me see those hands, let me see those hands, let me see them. Come on, let me see those hands, let me see those hands, let me see those hands, let me see them. Come on, let me see those hands, let me see those hands, let me see those hands, let me see them. Come on,
homegrown alligator, see you later. Gotta hit the road, gotta hit the road. Sun and change in the atmosphere, architecture unfamiliar. I can get used to this.
Di allargare la coalizione di centro-sinistra alla società civile con una lista civica. I sondaggi danno in testa seguito dal centro-sinistra che è in crescita rispetto alle prime rilevazioni di ottobre 2018 e dal 5 Stelle in calo. L'ennesima vittoria del centrodestra nelle regionali rafforzerebbe ulteriormente la Lega nei suoi rapporti con forze di d'Italia, come del resto è accaduto negli ultimi mesi in Abruzzo, ancora di più i pentastellati e porterebbe ad una inevitabile resa dei conti politica nella maggioranza di governo anche se rinviata a dopo le